Yasmin Ashrafi has been living in this camp since 1971, when she was 7. It's been a long, arduous journey since then. Now she has several grandchildren and wants them to have a better life than she has had.
We face manifold problems: unclean water, limited space to sleep, frequent electricity cuts, and so on. It's very hard for us to sleep, eat, and live in such a small place. You can't possibly stay healthy in such an environment. There are 7 of us who share this room, which barely can accommodate 2 people.
This camp is one of 17 in Bangladesh. It has just 1 school.
Conditions are dire in this camp. Nearly 25,000 people are crammed into an area smaller than the size of a football field. Houses are separated by a distance of 1 meter wide passageway used by residents and livestock. These small spaces are home to entire families with very limited access to basic services.
Recently, Biharis were in the news when dozens of people were injured in a fight between police and camp residents. The violence was triggered when authorities tried to cut the electricity supply.
There were protests in the camp for several days. I went to my workshop to get some work done during the fighting with the police. Suddenly, some stray shotgun pellets hit all over my body and one of my eyes, from which I can't see anymore.
Most of those living in the camp get no help from the authorities and create their own jobs. But they also face constant threats of evictions.
And now the Biharis are facing challenges like camp evictions and the passport. The authorities said the Biharis are citizens of Bangladesh according to 2008 court judgment. So they are no more stateless or refugees. So why they are occupying the government land or the private land? So the government is trying to evict the camps without any notice or without any settlement.
But where would the Biharis go? The government is considering relocating those living in the capital, Dhaka, to a new settlement. But 300,000 people spanning multiple generations fear they'll continue to face discrimination. Tanvir Chowdhury, Al Jazeera, Dhaka, Bangladesh.